Peter ban. Yesterday we talked about it. We had a guest in where we talked about the legality, the illegality of this, and Nigeria being a sovereign nation, even if they had the right, they're within their rights to say categorically they don't want a certain organization functioning in their country. We had that conversation yesterday. But today, we want to take it from a different angle. I mean, you're not here when we talk about the Twitter ban, YK and BC. What were your initial thoughts first before we now go into the effects?
Okay, so I know that Nigeria is a sovereign nation, and like every sovereign nation, they have a right to determine what happens in their space.
Yeah.
It's their rights. Nobody can fault them for that. But I have a problem with always not doing things right. I believe that they should have, you know, found a way to come to the table and say, this and this is what we have noticed about this particular network. And going forward, if you want to operate in a country like Nigeria, these are the rules and the regulations and the guidelines.
Government has every power to do what they've done. We're a sovereign nation. We cannot be apologetic to anything. Corporate entity registered in another country. That is my take. But because we are doing it at a time when it seems it's for the most frivolous reason, it looks personal. That's why we're having this conversation.
It's vindictive.
If Twitter is Twitter is doing his business and the cost of his business goes to the root of our unity, Twitter should be banned, destroyed, in fact, evicted, pata pata. That's what it should be done. But because at the time it was done, it looked like our president was addressing a personal issue.
Yeah.
We had issues that our National Assembly should have.
Bad tweets.
Thank you. Committee upon committee.
Bring
upon
them
committee.
Down then.
We have committee for uni. We must have committee for this for social media. We must have committee for communications. We have a minister for communications who did not think to advise the president at the earliest time to, you know, to address Twitter on issues that were divisive. Tweets that were going flying everywhere. Nobody talked about
They did not know. Thank you, Nima. Let me know.
I don't think that they should have banned Twitter because I think that it is not democratic. This is a democracy. It is not. If we're in China or North Korea or all those communists. So they should say whether we are social or communist.
It's also an indictment on us as Nigerians on how unpatriotic we are. Because many of us have seen, because we say it so easily, oh, the streets of Twitter are very toxic. The streets of Twitter are very, very, you know, they are combative. They are, you know, if you go there, you are, you know,
and they will roast you.
We say when we joke about it, for us it's not a big deal because that's where people throw out the venomous messages about the nation. Yes, we are yabbing each other, that's your business. But when you say such negativity about our country and people just laugh about it. So even based on what you said, we have seen these messages and we've just walked past. But then our president said something because we asked him to speak. He said something and suddenly we then report it so much that to get to the point where they now got vindictive by saying they are suspending Twitter. But the point is, we also should have taken responsibility for those who are uttering, who are sending out venomous messages against, divisive messages against Nigerians. That also should have been reported.
Well, if you are a reporter, then you should have reported. Me, I've never reported anybody on Twitter before.
You're not a reporter.
I'm not a reporter.
But, okay, please let me
finish. Because
I still believe that the government should have had somebody who was checking those messages and reporting them to Twitter.
Yes.
And saying, this is a divisive message. You need to delete this.
Yes.
And then we have evidence against Twitter. We see all the ones that we reported. So if I'm saying the wrong thing now, all the government has to do now is say, look, this we did report.
Yes. And they didn't do anything about it. So my worry is that we've been thinking of how to get money, loans, businesses. We want foreign investors to come. These are some of the things that they'll be looking at to say, are you sure we can thrive?
Erratic policies.
Yes. Are you sure we can thrive in a nation like Nigeria? Because any policy can just come up and we will lose money and lose everything.
Yeah. There's a gentleman whose story I saw in the Nigerian Tribune today, and it was really heartbreaking. His name is Elijah Peter, and he's a postgraduate student of one of the foremost universities here. He was talking to Nigerian Tribune, and he was saying that his online footwear store, Shoe Locker, his primary customers came from Twitter, and it was the proceeds he was using to pay for his education. So this is a man whose entire business
is on Twitter.
Has been run ground because Twitter has been suspended. Mm. So these are the economic effects, because there's that ripple effect of he's getting that money and he's going to pay for his education.
Yeah.
We understand the sovereignty of the decision.
Yeah.
However, at the same time, they need to bring Twitter to a conversation table.
When you are doing things, that's what a democratic government, when you are taking decisions, take your people into consideration. Mm.